Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom. In this quick video, we'll show you how to create an email signature, or several if you want, in Outlook on a Mac. It's quick and easy to do, and it can both save you a lot of typing and make your email look more professional. As usual with our videos, don't worry about taking notes as you watch because you'll find a one-page recap of the steps at the end of the video. So let's get started. To create an email signature, first open the Outlook app on your Mac. On the top left corner of your screen, next to the Apple, you should see the word Outlook. Click on it to open the Outlook menu. One quick thing to note here, there are two versions of the Outlook app, New Outlook and Classic or Legacy Outlook. Until Microsoft decides to get rid of it altogether, you can switch between the two versions by choosing Legacy Outlook here. That option is not checked on this menu, which means that we're using the new version. Luckily, the steps are very similar in both. It's mostly a matter of appearances, and we'll point out the differences as we go along. In the same menu, select Settings. In the Outlook Settings window that appears, you'll see a bunch of options. The one we want, of course, is Signatures. The Signatures window has three sections. On the left, you'll see a list of any signatures you already have, starting with Standard, which is just a couple of dashes. To add a signature, click the plus sign down here. A new window pops up with all the tools you need to create and format a signature. At the top is the name of the signature, which is just descriptive, currently untitled. And in the main part of the window is the contents of the signature, pre-filled with your email address. These are just suggestions. You can edit either or both if you want to. Let's edit the signature by typing in this part of the window. If you want to zip it up a little bit, use the formatting toolbar here to change the font, make part of it bold, italic, and so forth. On Legacy Outlook, your formatting toolbar is arranged a little differently, but the options, which are probably familiar to you, are essentially the same. One of my favorite tricks here is to add a link to the signature. For example, if I want to make it easy for people to visit my YouTube channel, I just select the appropriate text and add a link. We're not seeing a link option on the formatting toolbar, but that's just because the window is too small to see all the choices. To get to the rest of them, click the three dots menu at the end here, and now choose Hyperlink, or if you use right-click, you can just right-click on the selected text and choose Hyperlink from the context menu. Either way, in the Insert Hyperlink window, enter the web address or URL. You can copy and paste into this box too, you don't have to type it in. Click OK when you're done, and voila! Your email signature now includes a link. Let's give the signature a name, something simple like MySig, and we just have to click Save to keep it. All done with creating this work-oriented signature, so we can close this window. MySig now appears in the list of signatures on the left, and since it's selected, we see a preview of it on the right. Suppose you want a different signature for personal use. Let's quickly add a second one. Click the plus sign again, and let's call this one Alternate. I'll add some text, save it, and close the window. Now that we've created two custom signatures, we can choose the default signature, that is the one that appears automatically, for new messages and for replies or forwards. Let's make them different just for testing purposes. Notice that if you use multiple email addresses with Outlook, you can select signatures for each account. Let's try out our new signatures. We close the signatures window and we're back at the main mail window. Click the new mail button as you normally would to write an email, and your beautiful new signature automatically appears at the bottom of the message area. If you want to use a different signature in an email, it's easy to do, but we're not seeing that option right now because, again, the Outlook window is too small. If I stretch it a little bit wider, you can now see the signature icon up top here. Just click that button and choose the signature you want, or click Manage Signatures to go straight to the Settings window where we created them in the first place. That's a handy shortcut. In Legacy Outlook, you'll find the Signatures icon way over to the right like this. So again, if you don't see it, just make your window bigger. And finally, let's try replying to an email. I'll just use this one to test. Click Reply, Reply All or Forward, and we get the signature we selected as the default for replies. Notice that the signature automatically appears above the quoted text of the email we are replying to, as it should. And you're done! Here's a quick recap of the steps as promised. to add signatures to your email in Outlook on a Mac, open Outlook, click on the Outlook menu, Settings, and Signatures. Create and format whatever signatures you want and save them. Then choose which ones will be the default for both new emails and replies. If you have more than one email address in Outlook, repeat step 4 for each account if you like. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. Please click like if you found this video helpful. Feel free to leave comments and questions below, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.